Allah Ta'ala says, وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَذُو مَغْفِرَةٍ وَذُو عِقَابٍ أَلِيمٍ, that your Lord is of great forgiveness and also of great punishment as well. So one has to always have the awe and always have that sense of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has its beauty manifested in the creation. Each one of them, without the jamal by itself, the person will be lax, will be an inbisat, will be a person like extremely relaxed and so on and so forth, look for the, and so on. And then with the majesty by itself, the heart will be constricted in a very strong way. And then it's very difficult. There will be khawf, there will be tremendous amount of fear and awe that will cripple the human being. You don't want to live like that. Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us to be balanced. The tarbiyah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a balanced one. But in matters of how, what Allah Ta'ala creates, كل يوم هو في شأن, كل يوم هو في شأن, every single day, Imam Ibn Shajar rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi قال شأن كل يوم هو في شأن, every day he is translating it according to Imam Shajar. Imam Shajar rahmatullahi ta'ala said شؤون يبديها ولا يبتديها. These are matters that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveal. He's not creating them on the spot. He reveals all of that. Allah ta'ala, the Prophet told us, فَرَغَ رَبُّنَا مِنَ الْخَلْقِ, Allah ta'ala is done with creation, which means that whatever you see is created has already been willed long time ago before we even been created. So God is done with the creation. Right, what you see is how Allah Ta'ala reveals all of that which He created. He reveals it to our attention, reveals it to the world. Right, so one, when you think about what Allah Ta'ala reveals, one has should not be too preoccupied with that which has been revealed without looking at it from the eye of Tawheed. So one has to look with two eyes to the events that are going on. Each one, without looking with the two eyes, the person will be blind. When a person will be misguided, there will be methodological issues of the intellect and erroneous choices that intellect would go to that are completely difficult to come back from. The first one is the eye of Tawheed, that nothing happened in the dominion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except that He willed it. Whether it's good, whether it's bad, we believe in theology that nothing happens in the dominion of Allah ta'ala that He doesn't will it. You don't want to worship na'udhu billah. This is just something that the theologians say. Na'udhu billah. You don't want to worship a Lord who doesn't know what's going to happen. That events are ahead of Him. That's not a Lord we worship. We worship our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala who created every single thing. Nothing in His dominion that overpowers Him. He overpowers every single thing. He's al-qayyum. He has قيومية of every single thing, of every single. ما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها, ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض, ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب. Nothing that Allah Ta'ala creates, a leaf that falls down, that except that He knows it. Nothing that is moist or hard, nothing that is big or small, except that is written already in a kitab, in a book. من قبل أن نبرأها, before we make it manifest to the people, right? إن ذلك في كتاب, it is indeed in a book. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. For one has to have that eye, but that eye, as we just said about the dhikr, about وحدة الشهود, which is this one is part of it. It is an outcome of a lot of dhikr. It is an outcome of a lot of dhikr. It comes with a state of the heart. It's not just an intellectual state that you know God created every single thing. No. It is a state of the heart that you trust what Allah Ta'ala created. You trust that He has full command of His business. You trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's plans for the world. You trust His plans with the world. Nothing goes out of His wisdom. Whether it's starvation or flood or a tsunami or a war, or none of that goes out of the wisdom of Allah Ta'ala. He is al-Hakim. All of that emanates from His hikmah. And we have to worship Allah Ta'ala seeing that manifest. But then all of those events necessitate from us. Allah Ta'ala told us that there is a shar'i. We have to look from the other with the other eye, which is the shar'i eye. What is my role in this? What is my role in this situation here? What do I do? What is the sharia ask me to do in a situation like this? And if I don't, if I go with one without the other one, I'll be misguided. I would be with my direction. If you go with just the eye of Tawheed and not paying attention to what then you'll be a Jabri. You'll be somebody who is like, you know, determinist, and say God wants, and you don't do anything, and you just sit down in your place and you don't act. Well, this is why did Prophet Islam, what did Prophet Islam, he migrated, he went through so much because he looked at it from the eye of Tawheed, he looked at it from the eye of Sharia. He had to do things that Allah Ta'ala told him to do, and do them according to what Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, to what Allah Ta'ala had told him to do. So planning, working hard to alleviate the injustices, making sure that those acts of wars don't repeat themselves, doing our share. Whatever Allah wills, He will it. But what is it that these are ibtilas for us? What is it? لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Who is going to do better? Who is going to see things and react to the injustices and go and fight them and go and do the best we can do to do them? So this is the eye of the believer. So between the Jalal and the Jamal, between the eye of Tawheed and the Sharia, the believer has to be there in both of them. Otherwise, people will plan and will go through the plan of, okay, let's try to alleviate the pain of people that are going through pain and so on and so forth and so on and so forth. They get to the point where there is no ground of faith and trust in Allah Ta'ala that sustains them. And what happened after that is that a lot of people lose their faith. Because the amount sometimes of calamities, they go beyond what the person can handle psychologically, or they cannot find meaning of all of that unless they look at it from the eye of Tawheed. The moment they start looking at it, there is meaning in all of that. You take the meaning out, and then what's out there is just suffering. And then why is this, and why is that, and so on and so forth.